students. I am Stovar BK sir. That is, I just take the standard, 7th standard. I just take the subject physics and chemistry subject. Now we are going to discuss the subject chemistry. In chemistry, my topic is just physical change and chemical change. Physical change and chemical change. First, we have to discuss the topic physical change. What is meant by physical change? I just given some definitions and the examples in detail. Physical change is just classified into two or three categories. First category, whenever is any the changes takes place, the change has occurred in size and shape, but no change, no new substance is found. Whenever any change takes place, change has occurred in size and shape, but no new substance is formed. So this is called the first category of the physical change. So change has occurred in size and shape, but no new substance is formed. Okay, just to go to the example. First example, whenever if you just take one glass bottle, you take the glass bottle, simply just put in the ground, then the glass bottle just broken to pieces, several pieces. The glass bottle just broken into several pieces. Here the change in size and shape is there. Change has occurred in size and shape, but any new substance is formed? No. So no new substance is formed. Change has occurred in size and shape, that is a full bottle become half bottle, but no new substance is formed. Any other example is there? Yes, definitely. Second example, whenever if you take one vegetables, you just cut into several pieces, what happened? The vegetables continues to be a vegetable. So change in size and shape, the one become 1/4 or 1/5 like that. But any new substance is formed? No. So no new substance is formed. Till some more example is there? Yes. Take one beaker full of water, take some amount of sugar, add with it, then we get solution. Here size and shape in molecules changes, but no new substance is formed. No new substance is formed. So these are all the examples for first few examples for physical change. Physical change. Next, we'll go to the next video topic. Till some more examples are there. So many examples are there. First, you take one pencil, just break into two pieces. What happened? No new substance is formed. The same substance is there. One become off. So size change in size and shape only. Similarly, if you take duster, you add it. No new substance is formed, only change in size and shape. Till some more example is there. Take one paper, cut into four halves, four 1/4 quarter. Now if you match the 1/4 portion of the full portion, is there any change in substance? No new substance is formed, only size and shape differ. So from this we came to the conclusion, change in size and shape, but no new substance is found. Change in size and shape, no new substance is found. That is called a physical change. Till sir, that so far, how many examples discuss everything? Discuss as a heading. Okay, next topic. Take one chalk piece. Next, you just make a mash using water, add with water and make a mash, and what happened? There become some balls like that. Is there a substance changes? No, only the size and shape differ, but no new substance is formed. Next, so far we discussed so many examples. Again, we'll recollect the physical change, meaning of physical change. See this video, the melting of ice, one best example. Ice become ice water, automatically they again return to ice. Next, chopping of wood. Next, example, breaking of pencil, breaking of glass, bending of electric wire. So melting of ice, chopping of wood, bending of wire, breaking of pencil, breaking of glass. Everything is the examples for physical changes. Everything is the example for physical changes. Why? Because it is a reversible process. No new substances are formed. No new substance is formed. Only change in size and shape. Only change in size and shape. Okay. So far discussed the first category. No new substance is formed. Only change in size and shape. So many examples we discussed. Second category. The physical change means change of state of matter. Change of state of matter. Okay, that is a reversible process. That is a reversible process. Change of state of matter means, just to go to the clip. First you take one tumbler filled with water. And you just freeze it. What happened? Freeze means keep in the fridge. What happened? It becomes a solid ice cubes. The solid ice cubes are shown in the plate. So water become ice. That is called freezing. Is it possible to retain the ice again to water, that is solid to liquid? Yes, it is possible. Why? How is it possible? Solid ice cube, if you heat it, what happened? Then it become water. Then it become water. So water become ice due to freezing. Ice become water due to heating or boiling. So here the process are reversed. So it is called reversible process. So it is called a reversible process. So it is called a reversible process. Change of state of matter, what process then? Reversible process. Next clip, one more example. The same ice cream, you just take, then if you melt it, then you melt it. What happened? Ice is in solid form. Then after melting, the ice water become liquid form. What's the formula for water? HOH or H2O. HOH or H2O. Here melting means the solid become liquid, ice become ice water. Again the process, next process, boiling. So boiling means what? Boiling means water. The liquid become solid. Sorry, liquid become gas or liquid become vapor. Boiling means liquid become gas or liquid become vapor. For example, if you take water, you heat it, then what happened? It become a vapor form. Vapor form. Here also the formula is HOH. Next, freezing. The water is there. You just freeze in the refrigerator. What happened? It becomes solid. HOH. There is same formula, water for solid, liquid, gas. So this is the best example for change of state of matter. For solid, liquid, liquid to gas. That is the freezing, boiling. Again, you just freeze. Directly vapor to boiling, boiling to, vapor to liquid, liquid to solid. Next, some more example is there. Take one tripod stand, take beaker full of water, you just heat it using the lamp, then it will evaporate, then it will evaporate. Suddenly, if you just, after the evaporation coming, you just close the beaker with the lid and cooled. What happened? Cooled to 0 degree, what happened? It becomes solid. So vapor become liquid, liquid become solid. So this is one more example for the change of state of matter. From the change of state of matter, what do you observe? One process goes to other process reverse to same process. So the process will be repeated once again, solid to liquid, liquid to gas. Similarly, gas to liquid, liquid to solid. So only this is called a reversible process. Okay. Next, one more example for physical change, that is called crystallization. Crystallization. What is the crystallization? This is also the example for physical change. Not only the example for physical change, but also the change of matter, reversible process. The crystallization is the process for just for example for reversible process. Already you know sea water evaporated. What happened? What we get? Salt. So salt can be only received by the evaporation of sea. The same principle used here. This principle only crystallization only used for to prepare the salt from the sea water. Okay, go to the clip. Take one tripod stand and you just take beaker. It's full of water. filled the beaker with water, add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid, and immediately just pour the copper sulfate powder. The blue color powder is called copper sulfate powder. Gradually you heat it and stir it until it does not dissolve continuously. Then up to that, if you add the powder gradually, then after some time it just boiled and filtered and cooled, what happened? The ice powder become a solution become a crystal. So first the copper sulfate is in powder form and solution form. Next you heat it, boiling and filter and cold, what happened? Again it just attain the crystal form, solid form. So here the solution liquid form convert into vapor, and again it is a cold, what happened? It convert into solid. So this crystallization is the best example for physical change. Next, last category, third category in physical change, third category is a change of color but no change in mass. Change of color but no change in mass. So how is it possible? See the video. Take a beaker, it is full of cobalt chloride, that is pink color. The pink color cobalt chloride is heated, then it become a blue. You just observe the pink color cobalt chloride is heated, what happened? Become blue. Again you drop a simple little drops of water, what happened? It just become a pink color. So again the color retain, reversal process, but no change in mass. So third category is the change in color but no change in mass. No change in mass. This is the best example for last example for physical change. So that's all physical change. So in physical change, what are the topics discussed? The change in size and shape, no new substance are formed. Change in state of matter, reversal process. Third category, change in color but no change in mass. Next we'll just discuss the topic, that is a clip, chemical change. The second part of this lesson is chemical change. It is the largest topic. What is the chemical change? Chemical change based on two aspects. One is a simple concept, simple experiments. Next, complicated experiments. So chemical change based on simple concept and based on experiments. First we have to discuss the examples for chemical change of simple concept. So what is a chemical change means? But what is the physical change means? Change a second in size and shape, no new substances formed. In all cases, all the three categories, no new substances formed. But chemical change means not only the change is occurred, not only change in size and shape, but also new substances formed. Okay, but also new substances formed. So this is called irreversible process. Physical change means reversible process. The chemical change means irreversible process. Why it is called irreversible process? Not only change in size and shape, not only change has occurred, but also the new substances formed. Go to the clip. First example, take a wood, burn it. Take a wood, burn it. What happened? It never become wood. Never become wood. Egg you prepared as an omelette. The omelette never become an egg. So these are all the simple examples for the chemical change. Next clip, the detailed explanation. Take one wood, just heated continuously, then what happened? Finally it become ash na tamil sambal nu solluvanga ash. So the wood completely burnt into powder and powder like ash. What's the chemicals just mixed in wood? Hydrogen and carbon. The wood full of hydrogen and carbon, that is hydrocarbons. Because of combustion, burning of wood is called combustion. The presence of oxygen, the oxygen is needed for combustion. So in the presence of oxygen, it prepare as ash which contains carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide and water. Water H2O formula. Again, you just see this video. Take wood, heat, that is burn it. What happened? Continuously burn. After that we get some new substance, that is called ash. The wood contains hydrocarbons like carbon and hydrogen. Now after burning it become ash that contains the new chemicals, that is carbon dioxide and water carbon dioxide and water. The process helpful to burn and become ashes called combustion. So in the presence of oxygen only combustion takes place. In the presence of oxygen only combustion takes place. So the new substances formed. So not only change your sucker, not only change in size and shape, new substances formed. So only this is called the best example for chemical change. Next, some more examples. We'll go to the next clip. You just burn the wood again. Here the molecules are same. While burning the or before burning, what the molecules are same. That is called a physical change. The complex molecule becomes simple, simple molecule becomes complex like that. But after it becomes ash, then not only molecule change but also the new substances formed. So only the ash is the new substance. So the ash formation is the best example for chemical change. Again, go to the next clip. So far what we discuss in chemical change, the simple examples I explain. First, burning of wood is the best example. The rivet or nail rust formation, the milk become curd, the raw rice become boiled rice, and ripening of fruits. So once again I'll just explain this concept. Okay, explain this concept. See this video. Burning of wood, the rivet or nail just become a rust formation of nail, and the milk become curd, the raw rice become boiled rice. Okay, these are all the some other examples for the chemical changes. From this we come to the conclusion, physical change means irreversible process, chemical change means irreversible process. Physical change means there is no new substances formed. Chemical change means new substances formed. Okay, next, go to the next clip. The chemical change based on simple concepts discussed so far, simple experiments, the burning of wood, okay, like that examples discussed. But now the chemical change takes place also in chemistry lab using so many experiments. Very first experiment, the burning of magnesium. Go to the clip. First, you just take a beaker full of water and two blue litmus and red litmus paper, China dish full of water, and matchbox, spirit lamp, scissor. These are all the materials required. Now you open the spirit lamp cap, light the spirit lamp using matchstick. Then after burning the spirit lamp, you just take one piece of magnesium. This is a magnesium strip. The strip is just show the flame, then it burn. Then it completely burn. What happened? The yellow flame become white. That is white ash is formed. Then it is put in the China dish. Then after putting the China dish, the ash, okay, it is completely in the form of ash. Add a little drops of water by using pinch cow. Okay, and mash it in gel state. So the ash and water reacts. Now you just take some little ash solution on the blue litmus paper and red litmus paper. What happened? Both the litmus paper attain the ash solution, but the blue litmus has no change in color, but red litmus paper just attain blue color. The red become blue, that is color changed, but blue has a continuously blue. So the red litmus changes to blue, that is called chemical change. So oxides of metals are basic in nature. When it dissolves water, hydroxide ions are produced. When oxides mix with water, hydroxide ions are produced. Okay, when the magnesium ash is added in some other solution, we get magnesium hydroxide is formed. See this clip. The next clip, the reaction equation. What happened in the previous experiment? Magnesium burn. This burn means in the presence of oxygen, combustion takes place, burning. Then what happened? Magnesium oxide we get. So the magnesium oxide now react with water. What happened? Magnesium hydroxide. The magnesium hydroxide add on the blue litmus paper, no change in color. But if you add in red litmus paper, the red become blue. So the red become blue means color changed. So it is the best example for color changed chemical change. Next experiment. You know, generally the iron, if you keep it in the air or water, then it become a rust. Then it iron just put in drop in some other solution, then it change into some other metals or colors like that. So first you take different nails or rivets, onion solang tamila, nails or rivets, and take some copper sulfate solution in a test tube, nail and copper sulfate solution. Some other materials are required in lab. First you just take one beaker full of copper sulfate solution, nail, two test tubes are just fixed in the burette stand, and take some threads or wires or metal wires. What is the procedure? So tied the two test tubes in the two burette stand. Now tie the rivet or nail by using thread, put in one test tube, and in another test tube you just pour the copper sulfate solution through one test tube. The iron piece is there, the nail is there. Now through the other test tube, copper sulfate solution you just poured. Now after you just compare the both the solution, original copper solution and the rivet to the copper solution, what happened? The rivet to the copper solution, then the nail or rivet become brown, but the copper solution become green. So what chemical change takes place here? The brown color of rivet nail is nothing but copper is deposited. The original copper sulfate color is converted into green color. The green color just shows ferrous sulfate. The green color just shows ferrous sulfate. So copper sulfate reacts with the ferrous, we get ferrous sulfate and the brown copper. Just discuss the equation. So what equation? Copper sulfate solution CuSO4 reacts with the iron. Iron means nail or rivet. Then iron sulfate solution means the ferrous sulfate solution. Iron in chemistry like name the ferrous. So ferrous sulfate solution chola or iron sulfate solution green color plus copper brown. The rivet nail iron piece become a brown. What material? Copper is deposited. The green color solution is iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate. So here the color changes, chemical change. It is example for chemical change. Go to the next clip. Some more example is there. Take one plastic bottle filled with acetic acid or vinegar. You know vinegar, in the pickles vinegar only mixed. Okay, adulteration, pickles. So the vinegar is acetic acid, chemistry name acetic acid. In plastic bottle vinegar is there. Just take one balloon and filled with some baking soda. Baking soda na samayil soda nu solluvanga. Baking soda, sodium bicarbonate, baking soda vandu just you drop in the balloon, add the jar, drop or pour the acetic acid or vinegar inside the bottle. This is the acetic acid or vinegar, just pour it inside the bottle. Already we received some other quantity of baking soda in the balloon. So inside the balloon baking soda is there, inside the bottle acetic acid or vinegar is there. Now you just tie the mouth of the balloon and the mouth of the bottle. The whole powder just fell down inside the bottle. Then the baking soda reacts with acetic acid or vinegar. What happened? Immediately efflorescence takes place. So adding of baking soda with vinegar, then it gives some efflorescence. That is a Milky Way solutions like that. So what it indicates, inside what gas is there. Once again you just see this experiment. Add the baking soda and the acetic acid vinegar. What happened? Please wait and see. First acetic acid vinegar you just put in bottle inside. already what you just took in the balloon, just baking soda. Now you add the baking soda with vinegar. What happened? That reacts. Here the balloon be inflated. See this. Very nice experiment. The balloon will be inflated. What's the reason? Inside some gases are there. The baking soda reacts with the vinegar to get carbon dioxide in water. The carbon dioxide only the reason for inflating the balloon. The balloon inflated only due to the reason of carbon dioxide, evolution of carbon dioxide. You just do some other experiment. Lime water, add this water in Milky Way solution like that. That is explained in book. But I just explain only this experiment. It is very nice experiment. Okay, that is joyful experiment. The inflated balloon only due to carbon dioxide, evolution of carbon dioxide. And inside some water is produced. The carbon dioxide dissolved water is called carbonic acid. See this equation. Vinegar, the chemical name is acetic acid. Baking soda, chemical name is sodium hydrogen carbonate. That is sodium bicarbonate. That reacts, we get carbon dioxide and other substance, that is water. The carbon dioxide in water is called carbonic acid. Next, carbon dioxide plus lime water, that is the calcium carbonate and water. If you add the lime water, that is a calcium carbonate and water. Calcium carbonate is one of the chemicals. Calcium carbonate. The plus, in addition, water is developed. So this is the best example for to change as a new substance. Okay, next clip. The same chemical change contains some of the third category. Rusting of iron. In day-to-day life, just always observe the iron objects. Observe the iron objects at different places. See here. Okay, in public places. Okay, so many iron pieces and lathe shop. The mechanical shop. And some industries are in public places. Okay, and in a lathe, wheel, everything the rusted. So what it indicates, the iron objects in the open space of air and water, the grill gate and the benches in park. So everything is the example for rusting of iron. See once again the clip. So in lathe or in industry or in mechanical shop or some lathe patrai like that, okay, and a wheel industry and a net. So in so many places we just get the rusted form of irons. Why? What's the reason? The grill gate and the bench in the park, everything is rusted. What is meaning of rust? Rust means just iron reacts with air and water, we get iron oxide. Iron not only reacts to water to make a rust, but also in the presence of wet air. What is the wet air? Wet air na kattil eerapadam solvanga. Wet air. Even the iron pieces are in wet air, it became as a rust. So rust is the chemical change of iron, which are present in the presence of air and water. Next, how will you eliminate this? Some reaction is there. Iron plus oxygen plus water. Iron plus oxygen plus water make a rust. Iron oxide, Fe2O3. Iron oxide, turun solo tamila, that is rust formation. The rust formation is chemical name ferrous oxide, Fe2O3. For rusting, the presence of both oxygen and water. The water vapor is essential. Next, how will you eliminate the rust? Is it possible to remove the dust from the iron pieces? Yes. That process is called galvanization. Coating of rusted objects. The coating means in so many categories. Just to see the clip. Whenever the iron pieces are rust, then it is polished in industry. The iron piece just become polished. Even the ship, boat also. The external materials affected by seawater, so corroded, salt corroded the iron pieces, then to make a rust. So this is the rust formation from the ship, old ship. So stainless steel, how will you make a stainless steel? The nickel chromium some alloys are mixed with iron. Nickel chromium just mixed with iron. Nickel chromium are just like some other alloys. Then it is mixed with iron, we get some ever silver. That is a stainless steel. 70% steel, okay, sorry, 60% steel, 20% chromium, 20% nickel. If you add, then we get ever silver vessel. Ever silver chemical name, stainless steel. It's called stainless steel. So this is one way of coating by applying lubricants. So in this way, we have to avoid the rust formation of iron. Rust formation of iron. So how will you eliminate the rust formation of iron? By applying lubricants, coating paints, or polishing, or just adding out some alloys like a nickel chromium, like that. Okay, this is called galvanization process. Next topic here, one topic given the book, ozone layer depletion. This is also one of the best example for chemical change. Already you know the oxygen is only we just get from ozone layer in the atmospheric layer. Already you studied in geography, atmospheric layer consists of so many layers, troposphere, stratosphere, ozone layer, everything you studied in geography. Next to stratosphere, ozone layer, sir. See here, the ozone layer is just depleted, destroyed only by harmful radiations and chemicals. How is it possible? See this clip. This is the video of the earth, the outer layer, photographic pictures of the earth. Here stratosphere, here ozone layer is there. So the ozone layer thickness is 3 millimeter thick. The ozone means O3. The formula for ozone is O3, oxygen formula O2. 3.3 to 5 millimeter thick, the ozone, between the ozone and the stratosphere. Ozone to stratosphere, what is the difference? 3 to 5 millimeter thickness. Whenever the sunlight radiation fall on the ozone layer, the sunlight radiation, just radiation passes only through ozone layer and reaches the earth. When it passes through the ozone layer, okay, it produces some other harmful radiation, affect the ozone layer, then put the holes in ozone layer. In addition, if you use the refrigeration, the CFC gas, CFC means chlorofluorocarbon, that is a freon, chemical name. If you use the refrigerator, then produce a harmful radiations, chemicals, CFC. And if you use the aeroplane, the fuel is produce nitrogen oxides. This is the poisonous gases in the polluted in the atmosphere. Again, you just see the video. This is the entire the atmospheric layer of the earth. Two spheres are the stratosphere and ozone layer. So the stratosphere and ozone layer, so many ozones are there. That produce the holes. That is made by holes. Only by UV radiations fall on this. Whenever the sunlight radiation, harmful radiation fall on the ozone layer, then produce the holes. Then what happened? If the ozone layer just automatically make a hole, automatically become holes, then through this the UV radiation from the sunlight passes through the earth, and it's harmful radiations. So the whenever if you use the refrigerator, then some harmful radiations are produced. That is called CFC, freon. These also polluted gases. And in addition, if you use the aeroplane fuel, the white petrol like that, it produces nitrogen oxide. That also pollute the air. These polluted chemicals produce the holes in ozone layer. Then what happen if the holes are produced in ozone layer? In future, no oxygen at all. The earth will be warmed. Earth will be so hot and hot. That is called greenhouse effect. The infrared radiations are produced from the earth to atmosphere. Then because of the global warming is formed. Global warming means melting of Himalayas. So the Ganges river filled. Flood is coming. So impossible to live in northern hemisphere of the world. So the ozone layer depleted by UV radiation is a harmful event. That is an example for chemical change. If you put the holes in ozone layer, is it possible to retain the ozone again? No. So that is the example for chemical change. Okay, next clip. The ozone layer, a detailed ozone layer, I just given the clip. You just simply go through this. Now last topic, comparison between physical change and chemical change. So far we discussed physical change and chemical change separately. Now we compare. How will you compare? see the clip. First, you just take digestion process system. You eat the food. Here two process takes place at a time. At the time of eating food, the complex molecule become simple molecules. The complex molecules also food. Simple molecules also the food in the form of grains like that. So carbohydrates convert into glucose. This is a physical change. This is the example for physical change. But while respiration, the glucose is converted into some other energy. Some other photons, energy, glucose is converted to energy. That is a chemical change. The energy waves never it retain the glucose. So that is the example for chemical change. So once again, you see this video. In the time of digestion of food, the food complex molecule become a simple molecule. That is the example for physical change. Okay, the molecules only differ. So change in size and shape, but no new substance is found. But at the time of respiration, the glucose is some other substance, it is converted into some other new substance. So that is the best example for chemical change. So this one comparison, the comparison of physical change and chemical change is first, the digestion of food, digestive system. Before digestion, the food molecules, complex molecules are converted into simple molecules. That is the physical change. That is same like that of molecules only. So molecules will be a small size, that's all. Initially larger size, now small size. But after just burn, digestion takes place, what happened? The carbohydrates converted to glucose is the physical change. Now the glucose is converted to some other energy, that is the chemical change. Okay, next, some other comparison. What are the examples for chemical change? Burning of matchstick, burning of candle, digestion of lemon, digestion of food. These are the examples for chemical change. Next, physical change, cutting of lemon, cutting, grinding of sugar, dissolving of sugar, melting of wax, melting of ice. Next, mixing of lemon and salt and water. These are all the best examples for the physical change. Okay, next, a detailed explanation of the what are the process is constant and not constant in physical change and chemical change. Now we are going to discuss the topic, what are the processes are constant in physical change which is not constant in chemical change. Okay, here the physical change, new substances are found irreversible. Here new substances are found irreversible. Okay, physical change, new substances are not found reversible. Here you just take wax and ice. Most of the substance in some case same, that is ice, but most of the substance in some case changes. In which case most of the substance not changed, physical change. In which case most will change, chemical change. So that will be explained in the next video. See here, he took one china dish and one balance, electronic balance machine, and ice cubes. First he just take the ice cubes and measure it. It shows 33 gram. First he just took ice and measure it, 33 gram. After melting, the ice going to melt, heated. After some time, what happened? The ice become water, mass remains same, 33 gram. So the ice just shows 33 gram weight, the same ice become water shows 33 gram. So no change in substance, no change in mass. But in chemical change, you just take some candle, okay, candle before burning, you just measure how much of mass is there, you just observe. So measure the candle and you keep it on the balance, how much of weight, just you measure 10 gram before burning, unburnt candle shows 10 gram. After you lighting the candle going to melt, then after the burning of the candle, you just take the burned candle and keep it on the balance, how much weight it shows. Only 3 gram. So how much of masses reduced, 7 gram reduced. Where the 7 goes, 7 gram? That is converted to energy, heat energy. It is converted to heat energy. So, before, if you measure the ice, before melting, 33 gram. After melting, 33 gram. So, no change in mass. So, in physical change, melting of ice, no change in mass. Before melting, after melting. So, in physical change, mass remains constant. But in chemical change, if you just before to burn the candle, it shows 10 gram. After burn the candle, it shows 3 gram. Remaining 7 grams reduced. Where are the 7 grams? That convert into energy. So, the next part, energy difference. Next clip is energy difference. See this clip. Generally, the mass is converted into energy. The candle completely burned. Hydrocarbons are burned. The melting of wax is the example for physical change. But the burning of the hydrocarbons inside the candle is a chemical change. So, energy may be released or absorbed. Energy may be released or absorbed. If you take some alcohol on the hand, it's so cool. Okay, if you take some other hot substance on the hand, it's so hot. Why heat is absorbed or liberated? Absorbed means endothermic. Liberated means exothermic. Here, burning of wood creates the energy, lot of energy. But ice just going to melt only takes less energy. So, less energy taken means that is a physical change. More energy taken means that is called a chemical change. So, melting of ice to become boiling water, energy change is smaller only. It takes less energy only. But chemical change, burning of wood takes more. So, these are all the conclusions. New substance form, no new substance. Reversible, irreversible. Okay. Mass remains constant, physical change, not remain constant. Energy is differences smaller in physical change, energy differences greater in chemical change. Okay. Okay. That's all the topics. Okay. Thank you, students. Is any of the doubts regarding this? You just ask in Teachmeet app class, the evening time schedule. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much, children. Okay, thank you.